Hello, welcome to Tech Topics. My name is Jason. Today I'm going to discuss a new feature in 4.6, native Nutanix VSS Snapshots. Let's go ahead and diagram the before and after of this new feature. Before 4.6, in order to take a Nutanix VSS snapshot, we would send traffic from the CVM to the hypervisor, which would then, the hypervisor would quiesce the VM to take a hypervisor level snapshot. After this hypervisor level snapshot, we could then take a Nutanix level snapshot. As part of the cleanup, we would delete the hypervisor level snapshot. In 4.6 and beyond, we improved this process with the help of the Nutanix guest tools. This allows a CVM to directly communicate with a virtual machine to take a snapshot. As you can see, the 4.6 process is improved as you're able to communicate from the CVM to a virtual machine directly versus going through the hypervisor. Let's look at this communication at a more granular level. So once Cerebro receives the command to take the snapshot, Cerebro will talk to NGT running in the CVM. This in turn will talk to NGT running in the virtual machine. NGT will talk to VSS running in the virtual machine. At this point, VSS will pause and quiesce the virtual machine. VSS will talk to the Nutanix provider in the virtual machine, which will talk to NGT running in the CVM, which will talk to Cerebro, and at this point, Cerebro will take the snapshot. And the reverse will happen. Cerebro will send a command back to NGT running in the virtual machine. NGT will run back to the Nutanix provider. And the Nutanix provider will talk to VSS running in the virtual machine. At this point, the virtual machine will be unpaused and IO will resume. So let's look at this in action with a demo starting with Prism. In order to use this VSS snapshot feature, please see our other video on how to install Nutanix guest tools. First, I'm going to show you a virtual machine that we have my important file on the desktop. And I'm going to show you how to create a protection domain to back up this virtual machine using VSS. On the home page, click on the down arrow and select data protection. For data protection, on the right hand side, click on the plus and select async DR. And we're going to name this protection domain VSS. We can choose any name you would like. Check the virtual machine we want to protect. It is also important to note that you need one virtual machine per protection domain when you're using VSS snapshots. Check use application consistent snapshots. Select protect selected entities. You notice the virtual machine has been moved over to the protection domain that we are creating. Hit next. For the schedule, we'll just create a basic schedule that we're going to run once an hour. And we'll just change it to keep 3 snapshots. Create schedule. Hit close. If we go to the table, you'll see our protection domain that we just created. We're going to go ahead and take a snapshot. And again, you'll go ahead and select create application consistent snapshot. We're going to select for it to expire in 1 day. So now we're going to go back to our virtual machine and delete my important file. Now we see our second snapshot. We'll select the second snapshot that we just manually created. Click on the Restore button. We'll select the VM that we want to restore, which is the only VM. In the path, you can put the name of the container. And we'll just add the prefix name clone in front of our VM name. Notice the example is showing what the name will be. Hit OK. As you can see, the snapshot was restored successfully. You'll see the clone temp was created. We're going to go ahead and power on this virtual machine. As you can see, we have my important file on the desktop. So now we could copy this file back over to our active virtual machine to perform the file restore. So that was application consistent snapshots in a nutshell. Check out our other videos, and thank you for watching.